right, Denzel Desjardins, right off the mat here, literally right off the mat here at Michigan State. App State comes up, probably the southernmost team, but you win a tough semi and a tough final. Two slow starts, right?
Yes, sir.
Giving up the first points. What's going on? Why are you giving up the first points, and how do you overcome slow starts?
Well, I think now everybody kind of knows I was the underhook guy, so they always trying to stop that. But since I'm working on new things, I'm working on new leg attacks, they knew I'm still working on them, and I'm just trying to get to those because I know if I wrestle hard, nobody in the country has as good a condition as I do because we work hard, App State period. No other school in the country has better condition than App State. So I know even if I give up a takedown, I got to keep fighting. It's just like a warrior mentality that we have.
Going to App State, not in the Big Ten, not in the ACC. You probably had options. Why Appalachian State?
Actually, I didn't.
You didn't?
Didn't go to any tournaments in high school.
Where are you from?
North Carolina.
From North Carolina.
Only got second in North Carolina. Actually, the guy that beat me is on the team. He's our 197 pounder. So.
Do you beat him up every day just for revenge?
We don't even really wrestle, actually. But when I first came in, that was kind of my goal is, you know, to be better than him. Our freshman year, he always do one spot better in the tournaments than I did. So it was kind of like a goal in the back of my mind to just keep going and keep going and keep going. I'm the type of person, I learned from my losses, and I used that to inspire me to win more.
Football wasn't an option.
No, I didn't start until my sophomore year. I could have went D3, but I think I just started developing my skills in college. It just my athleticism. Because I didn't even know I was athletic until I got to college. They said, oh, this guy's pretty flexible. This guy can move fast. I didn't actually think much coming into college. I was just I had the worst credentials on my team as far as high school. Didn't win a state title, didn't go to any national tournaments. So I was kind of on the bottom of the totem pole. So I just continued to work, and as I saw more and more improvements, I started to get more confident. And last year is when I realized I can compete with these guys. I can even beat some of them. My goal is to beat them all.
You guys are in the Southern Conference.
Yes, sir.
What's it like wrestling in the Southern Conference? You know, you come from a traditional not powerhouse, mm-hmm. you know, of high school wrestling, and then wrestling in the Southern Conference. Are there a little bit of lulls in the season when there's 2 months and you're in the Southern Conference dual schedule? You don't get the competition that you would normally get. Right. Are there a little bit lulls in your schedule?
Yes, definitely. But we get into our conference schedule right after the scuffle, but then we still throw in hard matches in between that. Like this year we got Missouri in the midst of our conference matches, so they're trying to get the competition a little tougher so we don't kind of slack. And no disrespect to the SoCon, because I mean they do have great wrestlers coming out of there, but like you said, it's not as tough as the Big Tens and big powerhouses. So we coach doing a good job of putting our schedule together to make sure that we don't kind of
stay sharp.
Yeah,
stay sharp. I don't like to totally fill people's sentences.
No, I'm glad you did.
Stay sharp. Stay sharp. Coming up here, wrestling some Big Ten teams, how's that feel to you?
It feels good because I don't really get the chance to because we don't go to huge tournaments, but we try to go to scuffle. So the fact that we go here and wrestle a big competition and I'm starting to do well against them, it's a confidence booster for me and for these other guys like Mike Longo, Nick Key, Forrest Pribish. So, I mean, I think it's just a huge confidence builder because we all placed. Most of us placed. So it's just all right, we can keep going. And the beauty of it is at the beginning of the season. So we can see what we need to work on and then keep going. And then we got the scuffle. We're just kind of midway through the season and then kind of work from there. So I think Coach did a good job of designing our schedule so we can kind of have building blocks and different milestones.
Is it safe to say that you've kind of come out of nowhere?
Yes, very safe to say.
Are you happy with that? Are you okay with that statement?
Yes. Actually, I wish I wasn't the guy that came out of nowhere, though, in a sense, because now I have a target on my back. I liked it better when I was the guy that came out of nowhere, especially because a lot of people look like, oh, App State. They just remember Trotman. They thought, you know, it's like once every blue moon and somebody's going to come up. So I kind of like being the guy that came out of nowhere, but I don't, because now I'm not the guy that came out of nowhere no more. I'm the guy that had a good year last year, so now people kind of got a target on my back. I'd rather be the underdog and the guy that's kind of creeping my way under the radar and then making it big.
All right, Denzel, you got anything else for me?
Okay.
Flying back or driving back?
Driving back. Sleeper bus. I'm sleeping all the way back.
Congratulations.
Thank you.